This is my vacuum chamber kit. That's a stainless steel chamber. And that's a vacuum pump that sucks the air from the chamber. In order for the pump to work properly, it has to be filled with oil. You must use a special oil made for this purpose. The resin I'm gonna use has 2 hours open time, 6 to 12 hours initial curing, and 4 to 7 days for the final curing. You need a slow setting epoxy for this to work. In this container I will add the vacuumed resin. And in that I will add the resin as it is. My resin uses 100 to 60 ratio. So I will add 200 grams of part A and 120 of part B. Next, I pour the mixture into another container, add 6 drops of transparent red dye, and mix really well for about 2 minutes. Let's begin. I turn the vacuum pump on and slowly close the release valve. As you can see, I am starting to increase the vacuum level inside of the pot. The trapped air inside the resin starts to rise in the surface. This is about the maximum level my pump can go. Some people let the bubbles burst and then release the vacuum. I don't think that's necessary. Once the container is about to overflow, I turn the pump off and slowly let the air back in. I will repeat this process for a couple of times. Each of my vacuum sessions lasts for about 5 minutes, depending on my resin's volume. As you can see, the bubbles have decreased. That's the non-vacuumed resin. And that's the one from the vacuum process. The difference is quite obvious. Now I'm gonna let them fully cure for about a week. After about a week, the resin is pretty hard. That's the vacuumed casting, and that's the other. Now let's add a side light. That's pretty dramatic. And that's what happens if I move the light from the other side. To me, this is a success. And it is proof that you can remove the bubbles from resin castings using the vacuum chamber. Of course, you have to use a slow setting resin for this to work. I hope you find this video useful, but that was it. See you soon with a new project video.